Hello everyone, in this video I will tell you about some very basic commands that you can use to get description of your data. So for that purpose we will use a file from the system by using the command sysuse auto. So now we have a sample file over here. So here you can see we have variables like make, price, mpg, etc. So now if we want to understand the distribution of this data so that we can use it further for analysis, we need to know some very basic commands. For example, if we run the command summarize, so what it will give do, it will give you some very basic information about all the variables, like you can get the mean value, standard deviation, minimum and maximum values. So this is the command summarize. So if you will only write sum and press enter, it will also give you the same results. So running short like sum, it will also give the same results. So when you run this command, you get the information about all the variables. If you want to get information about some specific variable, just run sum and name of variable price. For example, we want to get summary statistics of price only. So now you can see here, we will only get information about price variable. If you want to get more detail about this variable, run it like this. Sum price comma detail. So now you will get the percentiles value 1%, 5%, 10%, 99th percent, and you will get the mean, standard deviation, variance, skewness and kurtosis. So from this you can get the distribution, the information about the distribution of this data. So after like summarize, you can also run summarize like this. For example, if we have a variable summarize foreign, so the foreign variable that we have in this data set contains only two values, 0 and 1. It is basically a dummy variable. So what we can do, by foreign semicolon sum price. So in foreign variable we have two values, 0 and 1. One is domestic and one is foreign. Now we can get the information about price by foreign. For example, when foreign, that variable is domestic, then we have 52 observation out of total 74 observations of price variable. We can get the mean value, standard deviation, minimum and maximum value. And when foreign is equal to foreign, so then we can see we have 22 observation. We can get the mean, standard deviation of this variable as well. We can also get the this information by running the command sum price if, by putting the condition if foreign is equal to 0. So when foreign is equal to 0, we have 52 observation, and when foreign is equal to 1, we have 22 observations. So we can also get the descriptive statistics by running this command. You can also get the information about this variable by running the command codebook. So if you will run this command codebook, you can see from here codebook, first we have make variable, which is a string variable, and there is no missing value from this variable, and there are some examples that how does this variable looks like, what are the values of this variable. If you will look at the codebook of price, you can see its type is integer, its range is from this value to this value, units 1, there is no missing value in this variable. Unique values are 74, means there is no duplicate value or repeating value in this variable. We can get the mean, standard deviation and percentiles of price as well. Similarly, we can get the information about all variable. If we want to run this command codebook, for a specific variable, then just write the name of that variable after codebook. So now after this command, we will get the information about price only. If you will run only codebook, then we will get the information about all variables. So there's another command, describe. By doing this, you can get the information about the variable names, their storage types, display format, value label, and variable label. The variable name make, its label is make and model. Price, its label is price. So you can get the information about this by running the command describe. If you will go to data editor, you can see in the make we have label over here, make and model. We can also get the information about type of the variable and its format from here. So this is also a useful command. There's another command that you can also use to get the information about distribution of your data, that is tabulate. For example, if we do this tabulate and there's a variable rep78, so it says that in tabulate we have five different values, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. The frequency of value 1 is 2, the frequency of value 2 is 8, the frequency of value 3 is 30, and similarly we can get the percentage and cumulative percentage of this variable. So you can also run the short form of this variable by writing tab only, tab. You will also get the same result from this command. So there's another useful thing that you can do. If you will do comma plot, so now it has plotted, and you can see the frequency wise 2 stars, 8 stars, you can get, you can see like how this variable is distributed. So we can also do it for other variables. For example, if you want to do it for tab price, in price variable we have one value for each different price, so we have only 1 star. So if we have a higher frequency for some variable, then you will get more stars for that variable. There's another command, that is inspect. You can get the information about the variable from running this command as well. In inspect, we can see make, its label is make and model, and you can see there's no negative, zero, or positive value because this is a string variable. If you will look at price, you will see negative, zero, positive values. There are all values of price are positive. So you can also get the information about any variable by running the command inspect. So there's also, you can see there's a plot over here in which we have hash values. So the value of length is from 142 to 233, and you can see, you can like get the idea about the distribution of data from these hash labels. If the line is higher, it means more concentration of that variable is on that side. So similarly, if you want to get value of a specific variable, just write inspect and then write price. You will get the information about price only. So there's another command, it called it is list. So if you will write it like list price, it will give you information about the all values of price. If you want to see list price in 1 by 10, now you will get the value of price in the first 10 observation. So if you want to get more information about any variable, just write list price mpg. So the value of both variables, and there are 74 variables. If we will run it like that, list price mpg in 1 by 10, then we will get the first 10 values of this. If we want to get the value like in 51 over 60, then we will get the value of price and MPG in from observation number 51 to observation number 60. So similarly, if you want to get the histogram, just write histogram price, the name of variable, and run this command. You will get the distribution of this variable. So these are some very basic commands that you can use to get the basic information and details about your data. So if you have any other question, just write it in the comment section, or you can also email me. I will try to get back to you as soon as possible. Thank you.